Hi, my name is Selina Soule, and I'm a 16-year-old high school athlete in Connecticut. I want to tell you about my high school experience so this won't happen to other girl athletes in the United States. I started doing track with my mother when I was 8 or 9 years old and loved it. I started competing in elementary school in the Hershey Track and Field Games and qualified to the state level every year as the first place winner in my town. Then my mother and I started competing together in the Nutmeg State Games when I was 12 and have been doing it ever since. I couldn't wait to get to high school to compete for my school since that was the only place a track and field program was available. Until high school, I ran cross country to be physically ready to compete in track. It was my dream. But my high school track experience has not been at all what I expected. I competed as a figure skater for many years and found the results to be subjective rather than objective at times, since artistry is combined with technical performance. I knew that that would not be the case in track and field, where the fastest time or the longest jump would win. All that changed my freshman year when all the other girl athletes in Connecticut and I faced another challenge, having to compete against boys. We all watched in surprise as our chances to win had vanished. The fairness in track events that we knew was gone. It only got worse the next year when another athlete who competed for 3 seasons as a boy started to compete as a girl just a few weeks later in the outdoor season. I qualified for the final of the 100-meter dash at the Middletown Invite, which features the best athletes in Connecticut. 8 of us lined up at the start line, waiting for the gun to go off and hoping to be the first across the line. But while 6 of us were only about 3/4 into the race, 2 girls were already across the finish line and butting chests as boys do in victory. Athletes and coaches watched in disbelief. What just happened? 2 boys identifying as girls happened. Before that race even started, the father of one of those girls said, "It's all over now." And it has been all over for girl athletes in Connecticut. Fair is no longer the norm. The chance to advance, the chance to win, has been all over for us that are just girls. All my mom's efforts to get the Connecticut Interscholastic Athletics Conference to review and find a solution that both girls and all transgender athletes, not just transgender females, have a fair chance to succeed, have gone unanswered. The media has been even worse, attacking us and portraying girls as sore losers and that we should try harder. We do train very hard, but when a mediocre boy athlete can outperform the best girl out there any day because of their physical superiority, we are just losers, not sore losers. I missed the chance to compete in the New England Championship this past season because of this. No one is listening to my mother and the other parents who tried to change the CAC policy. So I decided to speak up for every girl in Connecticut who lives every day in hurt and disappointment and who are afraid to speak up because of retaliation from the media, school officials, and coaches. Despite this, CAAC won't listen to my voice, but I hope Congress will. I will not be quiet about this. H.R. 5, the Equality Act, will impose a nationwide transgender athletics policy on America. It will endanger women and girls of all ages by opening up every sports team in the country to any male who self-identifies as female. This policy will take away our medals, records, scholarships, and dreams. I can't allow this, so I'm standing up to tell Congress. Protect us. Don't take away our dreams. Don't pass H.R. 5.